Hello and welcome to my Elite Dangerous day-to-day grind time all the time.
Cargo scoop retracted. Cargo scoop deployed.
We are at Jameson crash site. We have collected the encoded material. Now we're going after raw material. So I'm happy that you could join us. It's part of planetary exploration, but it's on our live account side, so the material we collect, we actually get to keep. The material that we collect on the my personal fleet carriers so far in Beta 1 and Beta 2 is lost. It's just a way to get to create the videos for staging the planetary exploration, the asteroid mining, all of that for video sake, but this is for actual future sake. So that double bar material is outcrop. Now on this one, I'm sure it's an outcrop. Every once in a while, it's not quite as tall, and it winds up being something else. But I believe, yeah, this one is an outcrop. That's what it says. And we need materials, especially raw materials, pretty badly in our in this account, in our live account. And we're not going after the upper levels this time. Strictly raw materials and material gathering, because we're still trying to find our way and how we want to handle combat rating. I did purchase a Vulture ship, and it's a small ship, and we're going to set it up as a pirate hunter, or when we're interdicted in the future, we might see about turning on them and try to fully mod the ship with hull reinforcements and shielding and burst lasers and just all kinds of stuff that the experts, combat experts, say is the best way to outfit those. So we're going to try to do that, and I'm going to maybe in the future look at more combat training, because that's something I do have a competent rating of like 22%, but it takes like 10 skimmer stinger kills for 1%, and we're starting to get attacked by support ships, so it's just really not worth it for the little ranking you do get. So just looking at other combat options at the moment, and I do use a VR. And if the videos do make you feel uncomfortable, maybe just glance at them every once in a while. Don't stare at them. And over time, I'm sure it will get easier, because in the VR headset, when I first started using it, I could only play for about 15 minutes at a time, and then I had to walk away from it for an hour or two. And then it was like that for 2 or 3 weeks, and it kept getting easier, and I could play longer. And now it doesn't bother me at all. So it does go away eventually. When I was a a teenager, when we'd go on road trips and things, I would get motion sickness. So what I started doing is take me a book every time we got in the car, and I would start to read a book for about five, or just until I barely started feeling the motion sickness coming on, and then I'd put the book down. And after a while, I could read in the car and it wouldn't bother me at all. So I knew it worked. And with the VR, it worked the same way. Still a little at a time, and it does get better. But we need the raw materials on our live account. We've been doing it in the fleet carrier, beta 1 and beta 2, but that's not helping us in our live. So now next month it will, because next month we buy the fleet carrier in live and we'll start doing planetary exploration, and it will pay off. But this time we're not going after the upper signals, only the bottom ones, only the raw materials. And we just got back from Dab's Hope, where we gathered manufactured materials and raw materials. And here we've already scanned for encoded materials, and now we're doing raw materials. And after this video, we'll head back to Babbage. We will pull over the Vulture that we purchased near Hippolis Hub, and we'll start outfitting it over time. And having that ship fully engineered. Vulture is supposed to be one of the best beginning combat ships, so we're going to use it with burst lasers and fully modded and reinforced hulls, hull reinforcements, and see if we can make a ship that we can fight the pirates that interdict us, and where we can win and possibly get more credit on our combat rank that way. So that's the idea. And when we get the fleet carrier in our live account, we will do more. And we'll, but like we're doing in our fleet carrier videos, is we'll do asteroid mining, we'll do planetary exploration, and we'll do manufactured material gathering and encoded material gathering. And we do have over 12 billion now. And when we get to 17 billion, we'll even slow down a little bit on our credit collection and do even more material gathering and working with the engineers and tritium asteroid mining and purchasing of tritium. But if we did material gathering, you know, once or twice a week over time, we would definitely have enough. I mean, I had been collecting for months and used almost all of it when I bought the 3 additional cutters and 3 additional pythons. That's what we're trying to do now, is replenish some of that. So when we buy the fighters and the long range travel, hopefully we'll have more materials again. Let's see what kind of time we got. Seems like it's been that more longer than that. No, I guess not. Yeah, the materials have been a little scarce. At first we had plenty, and then it kind of dried up. It was nice to see some. And there's been plenty of upper level signals. There just haven't been as many raw material signals lately. Assist view. Okay. Sys, ship.
Ship recalled.
I'm getting closer to wanting to get back to Babbage, as we still have videos to do on the fleet carrier side too. And we might go ahead and start back to Babbage and make that part of this video. Sis down. Just include the travel in with it. Sis left. Sure, I have Cios on here. That's not Babbage, so I'm not sure where that's supposed to be. That's better. Jumps. Sys landing.
Landing gear retracted.
And of course, it's always behind the planet, like every time. amazing.
Frameshift drive charging.
Sys alternate. But it's like 99% of the time it's behind the planet. You got all this space, but you always have to go into super cruise 99% of the time. Just a maze. As I would like, I always would like to have reality over obstacle course. Everything has to be an obstacle. Sys view.
Four, three, two, one, engage.
Okay, get back to Babbage. And we'll end the video there. And if you notice where you come in at the star, it's at the furthest spot away from your destination or the next jump. You almost have to exit the opposite way from your next jump 99% of the time. it's just totally crazy. It's totally on purpose.
Frameshift drive charging.
To make it as difficult as possible. Because you always want to exit the sun as soon as you can, but you come in at the furthest point from the next jump. See, it's way up there instead of down here, like every time. So you got to go all the way across the star every time to get, if you want to go straight to your destination. It puts you on the opposite corner.
Frameshift drive charging.
See, I would be better if they would just have you pointed to the center of the star every time. But it's the opposite end, opposite corner. See, we come in down here and the destination is over there. This time it's a little bit closer. Now, if it was random, that would be one thing.
Fuel scooping. Scooping complete. Frameshift drive charging. Drive charging.
Sys left. Four jumps.
Frameshift drive charging. Frameshift drive charging. Frameshift drive charging.
Okay, well, we're back to Babbage. Or getting back to Babbage anyway. But thank you for coming along. Make sure you press that subscribe button. Doesn't cost you anything. You get notified when I produce more videos, and eventually it'll help me out with YouTube. And in the underneath the video in the description, you'll find ways to donate. And underneath the video to the left, you'll see our YouTube channel page, GFM_RDG, where there's over 700 additional videos for you to watch, all created in the year 2020, less than 4.5 months old. So it's all newer content. And in the About tab, you'll find an email address if you wish to use it. Sis left.
Federal Flight left. Would like to welcome you to this facility. Access approved. Proceed to landing pad 09. Automated docking confirmed.
Sis left.
Landing gear deployed. Landing completed. Ground crew have been dispatched.
Well, again, I appreciate you coming along. Hopefully you'll come on the next trip. And we'll see you again. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.